reproduction. So here it is most important character of the living organisms, because reproduction is a process in which every individual produces an individual which belongs to the same kind. In the reproduction process, each and every individual produces young ones which are looking similar to them. So here, generally, if you look at, life only comes from the life. So life only comes from life. See, as per the biogenesis theory, as per the biogenesis evolution theory, so life comes only from the life, but it never comes from the non-living things. For example, we are living here. We came from our forefathers, or we came from our ancestors. Never a living organism comes from the non-living things. It always comes from only living organism. So that is the biogenesis theory. Okay, so living organisms are produced by the other living organisms, belongs to the same species. So that is the biogenesis theory. Biogenesis theory. So as per biogenesis theory, life only comes from life, but not from the non-living things. So how the life comes only from the life? So by the process of reproduction. Life comes from only from the life by the process of reproduction. Generally, in all the living organisms, reproduction occurs in different ways. For example, there are different types of reproductions are there. One is vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction, and sexual reproduction. Right, so here generally vegetative reproduction takes place in plants. If you take asexual reproduction, see, asexual reproduction occurs without formation of gametes or without fusion of gametes. The reproduction which occurs without formation of gametes is called as asexual reproduction. Sir, in the asexual reproduction, only one individual or one parent participates. Only one parent participates. And this do not form any gametes, and there is no process of gametes fusion. So here, due to the single parent participation, there are no new traits, there are no new genetical recombinations in the progeny. So here, asexual reproduction is different type. For example, there are different types of asexual reproductions are there. First one is binary fission. See, for example, Euglena, next Paramecium. See, Euglena, Paramecium, and also Amoeba. So these type of organisms performs binary fission. Binary fission is a kind of asexual reproduction in which one parent individual is divided into two daughter individuals. So that is called as binary fission. So binary fission is one type asexual reproduction. See here, next one, budding. See here, generally, budding, it is a type of sexual reproduction. A bud is formed in the individual, and when this bud is separated from the individual, so this bud will develop into an entire organism. So this is called as budding. For example, hydra. See, sponges. Hydra and sponges exhibits the process of budding. And third one is fragmentation. Sir, in the fragmentation process, a fragment is formed in the individual. So when this fragment is separated from its individual, and this fragment will develop into an entire organism. So this is called as fragmentation. So fragmentation majorly takes place in the Turbellarians. Okay, so Turbellarians are the individuals belongs to the Platyhelminthes phylum. So these are the three different types of asexual reproductions takes place in the different types of individuals. Let us see sexual reproduction. Sir, here in the sexual reproduction involves with the fusion of male and female gametes and formation of male and female gametes. See, in the sexual reproduction, gametes are formed. For example, if you take male gamete is nothing but sperm, female gamete is nothing but ovum. So male gamete is formed, female gamete is formed when fusion of these gametes cause formation of zygote.